Hi students, welcome back to IT class. Today we are going to start our fourth lesson, The Amazing World at Your Fingertips. This chapter mainly deals with internet, the history of internet, uses of internet along with other social medias. Okay, shall we start the lesson? Do you know what is an internet? Actually, internet is a computer network spreading all over the world for sharing the information. Okay, let's know the internet in detail. History of internet. The Advanced Research Project Agency under American Defense Department designed a computer network. Network means a connection of computers, connecting computers at four centers only, named ARPANET, for communication purpose. And this was done on 2nd January 1969. And this is the beginning of internet. So, ARPANET is the first form of internet. Internet means connection of computers. ARPANET consists of only computers at the four centers. Okay, and this was the beginning of internet. Later it is expanded as the internet that we see now by including many institutions and countries in this network. India also joined in the global network on August 15, 1995. Note that India joined in the global network, that is in internet, on August 15, 1995. Okay. And you have to note one more point. The full form of ARPANET is Advanced Research Projects Agency Network. This is the first form of internet. ARPANET is Advanced Research Projects Agency Network. Clear? There are computers in different parts of the world which store a lot of information on various topics. These computers are linked to one another and they function as a network. Those computers which are connected to these networks can share the information stored in it. That is, the information stored on one computer can be received or sent to any other computer which is connected in this network. If we connect the computers in our school to this network, we can also access the information stored in them. But don't think that the information on the internet is fully dependable and correct. It depends upon the person who upload the content to the internet. Now, let's look computer networks in detail. We have computer networks connecting computers at different locations around the world for various kinds of services. All of you know that, right? There exist mega computer networks, means a large computer networks connecting these type of different networks. This mega computer network spreading all over the world and the facilities given by this mega network is generally called internet. We get a lot of services through internet. Some among them are special facilities to learn lessons using internet, that is e-learning. Second one, the World Wide Web, which helps in the communication of information, www. Note, the full form of www is World Wide Web. Okay. Then emails to make correspondences easy. Video chat for face-to-face conversation, e-governance for effective execution of government service and for speedy access of these services to the public. Then e-commerce for buying goods from all over the world. Social networking sites that help us to build friendships, to share opinions independently between people all over the world. Further, advanced facilities and techniques are developed in this field day by day. Now let's examine how information communication, one of the major facilities on the internet, is helpful to us. Suppose you are instructed to find out additional information, images, etc. about the cell from the internet in the first chapter, Life's Mysteries in Little Chambers, in your basic science textbook. How can we gather information from the internet? Do you know? For gathering information from the internet, we have the following prerequisites. Prerequisite means something which is needed very importantly, that is must, in order for something to happen. Okay, the following are the prerequisites for gathering information from the internet. That is, if we have the following facilities, then only we can gather information from the internet. Clear? The first and main important thing is that our computer should be connected to the internet. That is, our computer must have an internet connection. Then, second thing, we should know where the information is stored in the internet. And the third thing, we need a browser software in our computer to help transferring information to our computer. Do you know what is a browser software? Usually, information from the internet is displayed in the form of web pages. As you have used internet for various purposes regarding your education, you are familiar with web pages. Web pages means any page that we can see inside internet is known as web page. The software which make this available, that means the web page available to us, are called web browsers. Some of the web browsers are Firefox, developed by Mozilla Project, Web Epiphany by Genome Project, Chrome or Chromium by Google, Internet Explorer and Edge by Microsoft, etc. Okay, so these are the three prerequisites for gathering information from a computer. First one is that our computer must have an internet connection. Second one, we should know where the information is stored in the internet. And the third one, we need a browser software which helps to transfer information to our own computer. Okay, now let's know how can we gather information. You might have noticed some links like https://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/cellbiology given in your textbook. And what does this mean? Actually, this is the address of the web page where the information about cell is stored. It is called the website address. That is, the address of the web page where the information is stored in internet is called website address. For gathering information, we have to follow these steps. Okay. Open Firefox web browser in your computer. We can see a page like this. Then type the required address in the address bar here of the Firefox window. Type the required address and press enter key on your keyboard. Now the information about cells which is included in Wikipedia, that is the online encyclopedia, will be visible here on your monitor. Clear? And let's note down the required additional information from that page. Okay children, this is the end of this part of the video. We will continue our lesson in the next class. If you have any doubt, ask me through the WhatsApp group. Thank you for watching.